The 5th of February started out much the same as any other. I woke up and got dressed, then took the tube to work. Nobody, least of all me, had any idea what was going to happen that day. Before I leave, I should collect my sidearm. The exterior credit exchange. When Hughes legalized private enterprise, he awoke capitalism from its 50-year slumber. Riverside was dreamt up and bankrolled by Harry Hughes personally. He saw it as the poster child for privatization, a prime example of the wealth and prosperity that would follow. But that morning, as I walked its streets on my way to work, most of its roads were gated off. Exterior was frightened, frightened of war events.
Thank you.
Took me a while to come to. Hours must have passed. I awoke to find Warsec thugs patrolling the halls of exterior security. In a matter of hours, Woodrow Bell and his band of criminals had brought society to its knees. Guards alive. All have been slaughtered by Woodrow Bell's private army. Thank you. When I arrived at the Riverside Tube Station, I found none of the conduits operational. I resigned myself to having to use the old maintenance tunnels buried deep beneath the primary complex. Miraculously, I had escaped any serious injury, and, for a time, I was safe from the terrorists. But the deep tunnels were to yield an altogether different conflict. First volume of Helm's Mysterious Prophecy. There are two other volumes, without possession of which, the text of the first is largely indecipherable. I managed to decipher vague references to otherworldly beings of vast intellect. Came across an inactive rapid conduit. Figured if I could get it going, it'd be the quickest way back to the surface. Sounds like the flow regulators are going. Let's give that conduit a try. Whoa! Hey! You there! God! Where is she? I would later discover my attacker to be called Evelyn, though I didn't realize it at the time. She was the first suggestion that the civil disturbance had a non-human orchestrator. It was at the academy that Glass first contacted me.
Lieutenant Redmond, this is Agent Ingrid Kell, head of Glass. We don't usually outsource our assignments, but if we can't trust the head of exterior security, then who can we? Redmond, the computing department was ordered to hand over very sensitive information to Glass. Unfortunately, recent events have sort of got in the way of that. Last we heard, Beating had the last copy of the research we were confiscating. We only hope that the insurgents haven't got their hands on it already. Retrieve it from Beating's office and we'll get it off you later.
Glass never bothered waiting for me to accept their assignment.
That's it. Thank you, Redmond. Your cooperation is much appreciated. We've unlocked the exit. Your expertise is needed elsewhere. Our intel suggests that there is a situation in the archaeology department. Best you check it out.
Before I was promoted to inspector, I worked in the explosives unit. Over the next few hours, my old skills would prove invaluable.
Report back to the Lunar Square immediately. A situation is developing.
I made my way to the tube station. My destination, Lunar Square.
The second volume of Helm's haunting prophecy. Humanity, divided and short-sighted, would succumb to annihilation at the hands of a vastly superior race of beings.
Use the bomb, Redmond!
safe. Stellar job, Redman. Return to the Council once you've caught your breath.
The insurgent threat to Lunar Square was pushed back, but I realized that this was just the first battle in a much longer war. I resolved to collect what supplies I could before heading for the exterior Council. So began the final moments of my sanity. I was terrified. I barely held off the destruction of the capital, but at least my mind was still unaware of the cosmic scale of the threat.
Redman, the managing director,
Fox,
needs assistance urgently. Get over there. Get over there now,
Redman. Kel? Kel, can you read me? Damn it! I need to get to Bax. Final volume of Helm's Prophecy. Alone, it was an abhorrent and grim text of little meaning, describing humanity as little more than ants. When I had time to study all three volumes together, I was able to derive their true meaning. Helm had been considered a mad, eccentric Englishman when he wrote the prophecy. Most decried him a heretic. His prophecy was, in its individual pieces, grim nonsense. But read together, the volumes told the story of the Visitors, as Helm called them. A sentient hive mind, a group of beings whose view of the world was without parallel to any human ideology. This race viewed humanity much as man might view an infestation of rats. Visitors would seek to undermine human unity, to plant the seeds of its destruction, to have humanity tear itself apart.
Thanks. Who are you?
Known Terrence Backs all that well. Yet I felt grief like I've never felt before upon finding his body. It wasn't just the death of a man, it was the death of Exterior itself.
Bell!
Hello, Redmond. It's refreshing to be talking with the scales tipped in my favor.
You don't know what you've just done, Bell!
I think I have a fair idea. I've just orchestrated the first revolution in half a century.
If Exterior collapses, then humanity collapses with it.
Humanity existed before Exterior, and it will continue to exist after.
You fucking lunatic! Wasn't wrecking 581C enough for you?
Oh, you will be but a footnote in the history I intend to write, Redmond. They will call this the Glorious Revolution. It will be marked as the end of Exterior's tyrannical rule.
Bell, what just happened?
What are you talking about, Redmond?
I
think you're in shock, Lieutenant. Maybe you should sit down.
Bell, you're not gonna get away with this. Glass
will be dealt with soon enough. I occupy the seat of power in the Galactic Empire, Redmond.
What the hell is going on?
My race has studied yours through the harshest of lights.
That's the first time I heard their voice. I'd later learn that they had been trying to communicate with me for months. Despite their vast intellect, our concept of language was foreign to them.
I see the corruption, the thirst for violence and destruction. On your shoulders is a heavy burden. The burden of saving your race from extinction and saving mine from committing genocide.
I recognize this place. I was in Exterior 581C.
Your race is obsessed with war and battle. Exterior's talk of an age of peace means very little. The citizens of 581C will attest to that.
I don't understand. Who are you?
You're needed at another juncture, Victor. Exterior's hegemony is at an end. Rest. There's much work to be done.
Hello? Hello? Is anybody there? Where am I? My mind was stretched to its breaking point. Exterior's colonial rule was receding, being replaced by a cruel new empire. It is here that I must break. I'm tired, and the story only gets harder from this point. Exterior was over, but humanity would fight on. The story of the battle for humanity, I shall save for another day.